With the rise of ChatGPT, the demand for prompt engineering has been growing as well. The number one skill to control generative AI is here, and companies are willing to pay anywhere from $175 all the way up to $335,000 for it. But let's back up for a second. In 2012, Harvard Business Review stated that data scientist was the sexiest job of 21st century. Right after that, the demand for the job saw an exponential growth, with many people taking it up as a career path. Around 2015, a company called OpenAI was founded and funded by some of the biggest tech giants, including Elon Musk. Their goal was to make safe generative AI accessible to the people. In 2018, they released a paper on improving language understanding by generative pre-training, which mentioned about the generative pre-trained transformers. In other words, GPT. The concept is what gave birth to our beloved ChatGPT. Since its release, ChatGPT has completely revolutionized how we look up information, and the way we do it is through prompts. In this video, we will look at what exactly are prompts, why is it becoming so popular, the main categories of prompts with examples, how to become a prompt engineer with a study plan and resources to study from, and of course, how do you make money out of it? So without further ado, let's get started. Now, although these large language models hold an enormous amount of data, they have no capacity to understand your need except for the prompts you give it. In other words, like an actual human expert, it isn't wired to ask you questions or to understand your exact need or context within which you're communicating with it. There's a popular saying in the world of NLP, garbage in, garbage out. Simply put, the quality of your prompt decides the quality of the output. Although you use plain English to communicate with the models, there is a certain style of conversation it responds to better. The way to engineer that communication style is the essence of prompt engineering. So why is it becoming so popular? You see, at the end of the day, prompts are instructions to reach a desired value. In any business, the goal is to reach this desired value as quickly and efficiently as possible. This allows companies to reach their business goals faster, and honestly, that's all that matters. Let's look at a simple example. If you have an online clothing company and you want to figure out the optimal marketing strategy and decide to use a service like ChatGPT, you can't just ask, "Give me a marketing strategy for my online clothing business." You would end up with something too generic and way too broad for your use. Several factors like product details, market share, target audience, etc. are very important towards creating this strategy. So the prompt needs to be engineered where all of this information can be fed to the model in a way that understands them and can take those factors into consideration in their entirety. This will reduce the randomness and edge cases and make the responses way more precise and tailored, which in turn will make them much more valuable. Once a certain level of precision is reached, businesses love standard practices. This allows them to control the predictability of the responses on a consistent basis, hence the demand for reusable quality prompts. Let's look at how business analysts work. They take the time to understand the customer requests and then communicate the same to the developers, but in a much more technical lingo. This means they need subject matter expertise in the business and also a decent understanding of the technical development process. Prompt engineers are in a way the business analysts of the NLP world of applications. Hence, to become a prompt engineer, you would need to build domain knowledge of the field of business that you're working in and a high-level idea on how the specific models you're interacting with works. The more experienced you become at these, the better prompts you'll be able to create for the specific use cases. There are many examples of prompts out there on the internet, but let's look at the main established categories among them. We will start with the one that we're all familiar with, simple prompts. For example, what is the sum of 7 and 8? The model here generates a response based on its understanding of the language and any other background knowledge that may be relevant to this. This method mostly serves our general use cases as they're typically the style of questions that we search on a regular basis. Then there is role-playing prompts. An example of that prompt would be that you're a tech copywriter with 10 years of experience and you'll help me create tech posts on Twitter. Well, that's a tongue twister. This type of prompt stimulates the model to assume the requested character or persona and respond accordingly. This method allows you more control control over the scenario and generate more targeted and realistic responses. Next, we have shot prompts, which are further subdivided into zero shot, one shot, or few shot prompts. The difference is that with zero shot, the model generalizes a response to the question without having specifically trained on the prompt itself. For example, what is the capital of France? Pretty straightforward, right? With one shot, it's fed with one piece of example or information. This is where you tell the model that roses are red, hence you look for the color of violet. Few shot, as the name suggests, is where we give the model a few examples before generating a response. As you can tell, this method helps you control the coherence within many of the relevant factors when generating a response. Let's look at an example to drive this home. Let's say you want to use ChatGPT to generate customer appreciation emails, but you want them written in your usual tone. You could feed it a few examples of your past thank you emails and ask it to generate responses maintaining your style. This will allow you to maintain customer relationships and reduce your workload at the same time. The last one we'll be looking at is called chain of thought prompts. This is where the model is stimulated into a step-by-step process similar to a chain of thought as it constructs the response. If we look at the previous example and modify the prompt to get the model to ask you questions about the customers before it generates the response, this way you can ensure the responses are unique to each customer. You can ask the model to consider their purchase habits, purchase frequencies, favorite color, etc., and think through them step by step before formulating the final response. Now that you understand how prompts work, you may wonder, how does one become a prompt engineer? And how do you make money out of it? Based on my research, I couldn't find any specific universities or colleges offering a dedicated program on this. Of course, there are courses within computer science majors that explores the subject in different ways, but nothing dedicated like a diploma in prompt engineering. However, this is good news, since it means anyone can pursue this career path and quickly offer their services to meet the demands of the market. There's a lot of resources out there, and I've done my best organizing them in a structured manner down in the description below. However, when it comes to self-study, the more important part to understand is how to structure the information consumption process. First and foremost, you should identify a focus area. For example, marketing, content creation, business strategy. Just pick one and go deeper. This will allow you to practice and build up domain knowledge quickly and also greatly reduce the overwhelm that comes with self-studying anything new. Then you need reliable sources to study from and a place to start. LearnProcting.com is one of the best starting point, and as mentioned, I have listed quite a few resources down in the description below that will serve as the next steps. So all that is left is practice. The more hours you put in, the quicker you'll pick it up. You don't need to necessarily understand how these large language models are on the back end. However, if you're interested, learning about how these models work and the basics of Python programming language will open up a whole new level of prompt engineering for you. This will give you more control over the prompt structure, since you'll be able to directly interact with the parameters of the model and make it respond to the prompts even better. I plan on sharing a video soon on how to use Python with ChatGPT, so subscribe and hit that notification button so you get notified as soon as I do. Now, to make a living out of prompt engineering, it's still fairly early, so you have enough time to learn and be ready to apply for the jobs as more and more companies start hiring. Just make sure you build your portfolio of prompts that you create and how to use them effectively with examples. Alternatively, if you want to create a freelance passive income, I recommend you check out promptbase.com, link in the description below. This is where you'll be able to sell useful prompts on a recurring basis. A word of caution, as you play around with these different prompts and find useful responses, please be careful on how you use these responses online, since AI detectors are also on the rise and Google is monitoring content that's AI generated. If you're solely doing this for producing content, it's important that you keep this in mind. That's all for today. Hopefully you found the information you're looking for, and the links in the description are sufficient to get you started. If you have any follow-up questions or have useful prompts that you'd like to share, please put them down in the comments below. Hit the like button and subscribe if you found the content useful, and share it with others so that it can help them as well. I wish you all the best in your prompt engineering journey. As always, I appreciate all of you. Until next time.